folks. Let's talk technology for a minute, okay? Now, if you've watched my videos, you know I'm old. When I was a young girl, our television was a black and white three-way combination unit. In other words, there was a radio over on one side, a turntable on the other side, and the TV was in the middle. Like I said, black and white. Now these days, you know, technology has come a long ways, and Nofer Blatz and I, like so many others, have a flat panel television. We bought this particular TV. We went flat panel in 2005, I believe. And at the same time, we also had to buy, or we didn't have to, but if you want decent sound out of anything today, you have to get a surround sound system. So we bought a surround sound system that had a built-in DVD player. Now, I didn't realize it at the time, but apparently that was a really good system. I mean, we didn't pay a lot for it, comparatively speaking. TVs back then in 2005 were really still expensive. I could have gotten the same thing today for a whole lot, half the price easily than what I paid then. The DVD sound system was a 5-disc changer, which really came in handy. For a while there, I was using exercise DVDs, and they could be left in the unit and not interfere with watching movies, things like that. And it had wireless rear speakers. They were good speakers. The sound was really good. It was a nice system. Was, past tense. One day this past week, it died. I went to go watch some television and no sound. It had turned itself, the DVD unit had turned itself off. I go to turn it on and it starts to come on and it shuts itself off. Try again, starts to come on, shuts itself off. It was a terminal error. There was no fixing it. So we had to go out right after work that day and go buy something new because, you know, you need sound in order to watch your television or your movies. So we decided to go to Best Buy, big store. We figured we'd have the best variety to choose from and the most knowledgeable staff because we decided, since we're going to do this, let's go with Blu-ray. You know, because that seems to be the direction everything's going anyway. And we don't have any background in Blu-ray, so we thought, well, we'll get advice from the salesman. We get there, the selection's not quite what we were hoping for. The speakers, massively smaller than our old system. I mean, some were downright dinky, but... And none of them had multi-disc changers. Every one of them only had a one-disc changer. And of all the systems they had, only one was DVD. So it's a good thing we decided to go Blu-ray because we really wouldn't have had many options. We start talking to the sales rep and Nofer Blatz pause like, well, what's the difference between these different units? And the guy's like, well, really nothing. They're all about the same. Okay, so much for the knowledgeable staff. So we decide, well, let's listen to the sound. Paul is a real audiophile. He loves music, for instance, and he's got a good ear for sound. So we decided to make that the basis of deciding which unit to get. We'll listen to them and see which one had the best sound. Many of these units have a built-in FM tuner, so we were trying to tune each one to the same radio station so we could compare apples to apples. And we had it, basically, we really were looking at three brands, a Samsung, a Sony, and an LG. Well, the Sony didn't have any remote hanging out. You know, the LG, there were remotes next to the units, but there were no remotes on the Sony. And I had already kind of weaned out the Samsung. I didn't like that one. So we were really down to just the Sony and the LG. Get another sales rep and ask him about this unit and the remote. You know, where's the remote for this unit? And he goes, oh, it's not out here? Well, you know, it should be there. Well, We pointed out to him that when we looked on the box that went with this Sony unit, it doesn't mention or show a photograph of a remote, but it mentions that it comes with a free media app that allowed you to turn your smartphone or your iPad into a remote control for the unit. Okay, does that mean that there isn't an actual real physical remote to use? And the salesman's like, no, I'm sure there is. Let me go look. And he's going to look in their little drawer where they have surplus remotes. He finally comes back. Meanwhile, we were just listening to the speakers and trying to decide which unit we liked. He finally comes back with a handful of remotes, none of them are the right one. So that we could still hear this one, he said, well, let me get an audio disc. And he puts an audio CD in there so we could listen to the audio CD to at least hear the speakers. I mean, we can't do an apple-to-apples comparison because we're listening to different music, but we'll try it. Meanwhile, he went to go ask somebody else about the remote for this unit, because we pointed out, is it really possible that this does not ship with a remote? And he thought that was insane. Of course not. It has to. Well, a different salesman, so this is salesman number three that comes, that we're now talking to, comes over to us and says, nope, doesn't come with a remote. Excuse me? How do you sell something like this without a remote in this day and age? I guess they assume everybody's got a smartphone or an iPad. Well, you know what? We don't. I mean, Nofer Blitz and I work from home. So we have accessible to us 5 desktop computers and a laptop with a DSL internet connection. We don't need smartphones or iPads. We're never out and about. I mean, we rarely do go out and about, you know, and when we do, it's just, you know, short trips. We don't need a fancy schmancy smartphone with a data plan, not when we've got DSL and all of our 5 different computers here in the house. You know, I've got 2 workstations, a Windows box behind me and my Mac. Nofer Blatz has 2 workstations. He's got a Windows box behind him and his Linux computer. The 5th desktop is the server for our internal network. And then, like I said, we have a laptop. I don't want an iPad. I don't want to have to use a touch screen to type something. And I don't need it. I've got much better equipment. I couldn't believe it. There's Sony, a big name, a big company. And this is what they're doing. My personal belief is they're doing this to save money. It's cheaper to hire a programmer to whip up an app real quick and be done with it than having to manufacture a remote that works with infrared technology and, you know, you got all the materials involved. And I figure it's just a way to save money. That's all it is. But meanwhile, they're going to lose business. They lost us. I was leaning towards the Sony just because it's a Sony. But I can't have that. You know? I mean, who wants to use their smartphone as their television remote? I mean, really? It's just stupid. What if I'm trying to talk on the phone at the same time? Or, you know, you assume I have an iPad. I'm not going to go buy an iPad just to be my remote for this system. That's insane. So we went with the LG. Now, I mentioned earlier that the old system we had apparently was much higher end than I would have ever thought. Nothing out there today that we saw had multi-disc changers. Everything was just a one-disc changer. Okay, I don't get that anymore. We had a hard time finding one with wireless rear speakers that didn't cost an arm and a leg. The lower-end systems are fully wired speakers. I mean, thankfully, the system we bought, they had 2 LGs, a low-end and a high-end, so to speak. The low-end they were out of stock on, so we had to get the other one. And it does have wireless rear speakers. But, I mean, it was a little over $400 for this thing. It was very, very frustrating. And the frustration didn't end there. Yeah, we were in the store for easily an hour trying to resolve this and settle on a unit, maybe even a little more than an hour. We get it home. We were both starving. We wolf down some food, and then we start working on getting this integrated into the rest of our system. Now, we're not, because I know we're old and that makes people think you don't know equipment and technology. That's, you know, bogus. We deal with technology on a day-to-day basis with all of our computers and things. And we've got a whole lot of components in our home entertainment system. Unfortunately, Nofer Blatz got it dialed in on how to wire it when we bought this DVD player and the flat panel, you know, in 2005. But this new unit, the Blu-ray unit, wires up a little differently. So we had to throw that out of the window and come up with a whole different way of wiring it. Now let me show you what Nofer Blatz does. This, if you can see it, is the diagram for the wiring of all these components. We have a lot of different pieces. We've got the television. We've got the cable company's DVR that we don't actually use because we use TiVo. So there's another component. Because we use TiVo instead of the cable company's DVR, we have to have a tuning adapter because the cable company, like so many, is going with Switch Digital. I don't want to get into a big explanation on what that is. And we've got that. We've got the home theater Blu-ray player in there. We've got my Wii in there. So all these have to be wired up. I mean, we actually do still have out there in the living room, just not connected to anything, our old VCR and our original Series 1 TiVo unit, I guess as a fallback. One of these days we should just get rid of these things because when am I going to use them? We do still have a few videotapes, so I guess if we wanted to watch them, we could hope the VCR still works. But trying to get all this rewired now so that everything worked correctly took a lot longer than we expected. Because of the different requirements for wiring this up, we got it all hooked up and we thought, okay, great. We tested it with a Blu-ray disc. We bought a couple of movies while we were there. And we tested out one of the Blu-rays, just watched a little snippet to see if it was working okay. Great, good. Close that out. Go to television. No sound. It wasn't the signal that goes via the TiVo. We were only getting video, no audio. Same for, I think at the time, same for the cable box. But so we had to change the wiring again and test it, try it, test it. We got it to work where we could get sound from the cable DVR, but not the TiVo. And then he rearranged things and we were getting the signal for the TiVo, the video for the TiVo, but the audio from the cable box. No, that's not right. We finally got it with some more cabling, finally got it to all work, but it took until midnight to get this up and fully functional, and then everything cleaned up. The old stuff pulled out and put away. We got to figure out what we're going to do. We got to do something with the old equipment. It was a hassle. It all works, and the sound is pretty good. Even though these speakers are smaller than our old system speakers, the sound is pretty good. And then the next day, I told my daughter what we'd gone through and how much it cost, which was more than I really wanted to spend. But she sends me a snapshot of a system from Walmart, because she was at Walmart the next day, that was $148, which is a whole lot less than we spent. But then again, it had some dinky, dinky little tiny speakers, and I doubt we would have liked it. So it's done, it's working, and we're happy, you know. And it has a remote, so we can use it. But I was just amazed. Can you even imagine a company selling a system like this without a remote? Go figure. Anyway, that's all for this week. Come back and see me.
See ya!